العبرة من هنا، لماذا قصصت عليكم هذه القصة؟ هؤلاء القوم هناك شيء كان عظيما في قلبهم، ليلهم ونهارهم، صباحهم ومسائهم، بهذا الهم يستيقظون، وبهذا الهم ينامون، وبهذا الهم يسافرون. ما هو هم؟ المغفرة، يريدون المغفرة، المغفرة. فأنا يا حجاج بيت الله الحرام أقول لكم أعظم الرغبة في المغفرة. شوف أنت، كل واحد منا عنده مشاكل كثيرة وعنده أسئلة وعنده، لكن لتكن رغبتك الأعظم أن يغفر الله لك، فإن غفر لك فقد فزت فوزا عظيما.
The sheikh said that I want to give you some nasiha, something valuable for himself and to you all, a gift. And he narrated to us by meaning, so he's paraphrasing a story that's narrated in the Sunnah, in the Sunan rather. And he said that the people of the Ansar, the tribe that used to live in Medina, they were farmers. They were an agricultural people, and they depended a lot on their crops, and especially the date palms, which require a huge amount of water, and the getting of water to them was very difficult, very, very difficult. And so when things became even worse, they decided that, wouldn't it be a good idea for us to dig a trough, like what's a khandaq? Trough, right? A canal, a trench, that would be able to take the water that falls down from the mountains and collect it when it rains, and then that way we can be able to deal with our animals, deal with our agriculture. That'd be a great idea. But we need men to build this. So why don't we send a delegation, the best of us, to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and hopefully we'll ask him that, and hopefully, you know, he might help us out a little. So they produced a delegation, representative of all the people, and they came to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to love the people of the Ansar. He used to love this tribe. And he said, if it wasn't for the Hijrah, I would want to be from you people. If there's Ansar take one path and another people take another path, I'm with the Ansar. So when he saw them and they came upon him, he said, Marhaba, welcome, welcome. We're so happy actually to see them. And he said that, you know, that whatever you want, ask me whatever, if there's anything I can help you with. And there is nothing that you will ask except that I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give it to you. You will receive it. So these guys have come with a very clear mission. They're here to just get a few people to help dig this canal to get this water sorted, this problem sorted. But they just stopped and they said, hold on, what we've just heard there is that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam just said that I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you whatever you want. Don't even worry about it. So they just said, just one second. So they went back to have a little discussion, like, you know, hold on, we can ask for more here. And the Sheikh said that, you know, what they were asking for was a small matter of a few men to dig, but actually what they could have asked is then for Allah to bring forth a whole river or a source from the ground without any of the labor. They could have asked for so much. So they had a little bit of a discussion and they agreed immediately what they're going to say. So they went back to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they said to him, Ya Rasulullah, we ask you to ask Allah for forgiveness for us. We ask you to ask Allah to forgive us. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did exactly that. And they went back to the Ansar and they told them this news. And there wasn't disappointment, but rather delight. Because, as the Sheikh said, the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke so highly of the Ansar and the Muhajireen, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them in the Quran, is because their absolute number one concern, despite all of their needs, despite of their real, very real needs, was the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be forgiven for their sins. And he basically said, the reason I tell you this story is because many of us have come with many, many different problems. Everybody has an issue. Everybody wants to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these last few days, today and then tomorrow. And they are real and genuine needs. And you all deserve to ask for that. But your number one concern is to be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The successful one, as we said before, is the one who is forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So show, make it your number one priority and your number one concern, and make forgiveness your number one goal in life and tomorrow at this moment of special dua. This is his advice This is the advice of the people of Khair. This is the advice of the people of Hajj. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make your Hajj easy and to accept it from you. We are so, so grateful that the Shaykh is here. We will ask him to make a dua for us. I hope that you will join us in this dua. The Shaykh does awesome dua. فَجْزَكُمْ اللَّهُ كُلَّ خَيْرٍ.
الحمد لله اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اللهم يا من أظهر الجميل وستر القبيح يا من لا يؤاخذ بالجريرة ولا يهتك الستر يا عظيم العفو يا حسن التجاوز يا باسط اليدين بالرحمة يا واسع المغفرة يا صاحب كل نجوى ويا منتهى كل شكوى يا كريم الصفح يا عظيم المن يا مبدئ النعم قبل استحقاقها يا ربنا ويا سيدنا ويا خالقنا ويا غاية رغبتنا نسألك يا الله ألا تشوه خلقنا بالنار. اللهم نجنا من النار، 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 اللهم نجنا من النار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة في الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم تقبل منا ما وفقتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم كمل لنا مناسك الحج يا أرحم الراحمين، ويسر لنا سبله يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، واجعله كاملا مكملا يا رب العالمين، ثم تقبله منا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل هذا الحج لنا حجا مبرورا، وذنبا مغفورا، سعيا مشكورا، تجارة لن تبور. اللهم اجعله لنا هداية فيما بقي لنا من الأيام يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يرجعون بالهداية إلى بيوتهم وإلى أوطانهم سالمين غانمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنك قلت في حق بيتك إن أول بيت وضع للناس للذي ببكة مباركا وهدى للعالمين، فنسألك برحمتك أن تنيلنا من تلك البركة يا رب العالمين، وأن ترزقنا من هذا الهدى الذي قلت فيه هدى للعالمين يا رب العالمين. اجعلنا يا الله هادين مهديين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم إنا نسألك خير ما سألكه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، نعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بك يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنه على تقصيرنا وظلمنا وكثرة ذنوبنا أذنت لنا في القدوم إلى بيتك الحرام وإلى بلدك الحرام وإلى بقاعك المطهرة. اللهم فعلت ذلك بنا يا الله، ولسنا أهلا لذلك، ما فعلت بعد ذلك بنا إلا بكرمك وإحسانك يا مولانا. فبإحسانك وكرمك وجودك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام إلا غفرت لنا. اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا، اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا، اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، واصلح لنا في ذرياتنا، لا تدع لنا في مجمعنا هذا وفي جموع الحجاج جميعا ذنبا الا غفرته، ولا هما الا فرجته، ولا دينا الا قضيته، ولا مكروبا الا نفست كربته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا حاجة لي لك رضا، ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يسر لنا تلاوة القرآن، اللهم اجعل حفظه وفهمه في أفئدتنا، واجعل العمل به على جوارحنا، واجعل حسن تلاوته على ألسنتنا، واجعلنا يا رب العالمين ممن يتلوه حق تلاوته ويرعاه حق رعايته، إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. جزاكم